It's a great honor to be standing in this position representing the Democratic Progressive Party as a candidate for the president and vice presidential election campaign of 2024. 那我在开始之前，有首先要跟我们许多国内的媒体记者、好朋友们，先说声辛苦了哦。那也非常感谢你们过去这段时间的包容啊。我知道我有时候低调到让你们找不到，那事实上我是需要一些空间来思考，我这个未来的路该怎么走。 那当最后的决定还没有完成之前，其实也是要专注很多当下的工作跟任务哦。那当然现在来承担副总统候选人的这个角色，也期待未来就各项政策理念能够有机会持续跟各位沟通。To all the friends of the international press and media. I used to be in that position, Vincent and Ya Hui were in since the year 2020. I've been in that job at least three times in successive presidential campaigns and elections. So this is not a task unfamiliar to me. But I must say that in this new role that I play, I shoulder a much heavier burden, especially under present international and strategic circumstances. The democracy, the peace, stability, and prosperity of Taiwan is a very important responsibility that we will shoulder as we move ahead in the campaign and in the following years. Now, for those of you who are Americans, today is Thanksgiving, and it's a day to express thanks. And I want to express my thanks and gratitude to the people of Taiwan for their resilience and their commitment to democracy. I previously served as Taiwan's representative to the United States for over 3 years. I've also played roles in Taiwan politics that bring me from very grassroots, rural counties of Taiwan to urban Taipei. So I bring to this campaign experience, pragmatism, and balance. I reference experience in the context that in former roles, I have focused on issues ranging from agriculture, marriage equality rights, transportation, balancing urban and rural development, digital equality, and many other issues. But I also bring to this campaign experience working with my American counterparts in the United States on our shared values and interests. The pragmatism and balance that I have referenced has been a very important component of my work in Washington, D.C., as I must balance multiple stakeholders and varying interests, finding that largest common denominator of our shared interests in peace, prosperity for our peoples, stability, and of course, protecting our democracies. Throughout this campaign, our presidential candidate, William Lai, has reiterated his approach to international relations and our external partnerships in the context of four pillars involving defense deterrence, economic security and resilience, international partnerships, and principled and pragmatic cross-strait relations. As I join his ticket, I also join his commitment to these four pillars. Now, the decision to come back to run for office was not an easy one. And I must admit I had tremendous hesitations about rejoining the complicated political environment in Taiwan. But now that the decision has been made, I am committed to joining William Lai in leading Taiwan ahead in defending and protecting our democracy, our freedom, our basic rights, and opportunities for our people to build greater prosperity in our society. I look forward to the trust and confidence of the Taiwanese people. I also look forward to the continuing trust and confidence of our friends in their international community. Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador Hsiao. Now, if you could just stay on stage for a minute while we adjust the seats, we will begin the QA session shortly. Again, a short reminder that I would like to ask our friends from the media to identify themselves and their affiliations before asking questions. Questions will be answered in the language asked. A Chinese language transcript of the question and answer period will be provided following the event.
今天稍后即将进行的媒体提问，要欢迎各位媒体在举手之后能够先说自己的媒体公司名字和自己的姓名。那么我们今天的进行呢，有国际媒体也有本国媒体，我们将会交叉来提问。谢谢。
Okay, well, I guess this is the moment everybody's been waiting for in terms of the question and answer period. So our time is somewhat limited, so I would like to ask all of you to keep your questions a bit brief, and then we'll start with a quick question from the a member of the international press today. So maybe in the front row, Ben, please.
Thank you, Ambassador Hsiao. I'm Ben Blanchard from Reuters. You have been sanctioned twice by the Chinese government. The Chinese government has made it very clear it does not at all approve of you standing with Vice President Lai. Under this situation, how would your administration go about being able to have any kind of dialogue or communication with China? How do you get over that problem, seeing as China really does seem to hate the both of you? Thank you.
I'll just quickly summarize that in Chinese. 这个刚刚路透社的记者有提到说，因为这个肖大使过去被中国制裁，未来要如何这个管理跟处理这个两岸事务？
Well, it happens that I'm not the only one on the sanction list. And the list is also shared by many other international friends who have been staunch advocates for democracy and human rights. I will continue to forge ahead in my commitment to defending Taiwan's democracy. I think we have reiterated our position that we remain open to dialogue, that we are also committed to the status quo. And as we take a pragmatic approach to balancing our international partnerships, I think it's also important that the international community, who also agrees with our position in continuing peace and stability in the Taiwan Strait, make clear to our counterparts across the Taiwan Strait that dialogue is the only way to resolve differences. War is not an option.
Thank you. Now, we'd like to open up the second question. Also from the international press, we'll take the second question. Maybe the gentleman in the third row on my left. Yes. That's right. representative of 日本共同通讯社。
谢谢主持人，收到信你好，我是日本共同社的记者。前一阵子，中国国家主席习近平在美中首脑会谈当中否认了2027年以及2035年攻台的计划。请问邵大使，你个人对这个习近平的发言怎么解读？谢谢。
This was a quick question from our friends in Japan, the Japanese media, asking about the aftermath of the summit at APEC.
我们在 APEC 期间看到美国的拜登总统以及习近平主席的对话过程里面，美方拜登总统重申对台海和平稳定的支持以及坚持。那当然我们也期待也希望习近平主席所谓没有攻台时间表的这个论述是真心诚意的。当然我们也真心诚意的希望能够寻求跟对岸的最大公约数，也就是维持台海和平稳定的现状。那早年雷根总统时期跟苏联之间曾经有一个论述叫 Trust but verify， 也就是相信但是要再确认。那我们也愿意以善意来看待任何寻求和平的机会，但是我们也需要强化自身的实力，我们才能够更有自信更有信心来面对对岸，我们也才能更有信心来确保台海的和平跟稳定。
We will take the next question from a local reporter. 本地媒体的提问。TVBS 新闻网邵瑜。
TVBS 新闻网吴少宇想请教大使，富士康遭查税，郭董被罚8.8万，是否是中国借选在警告郭台铭？您怎么看待中国的角色？另外，国台办说您跟赖清德的组合是毒上加毒，您认同吗？
针对第一个问题哦，我们从1996年第一次有总统直选以来，每一次的大选都可以看到中共借选的影子。那当然在这个过程当中，对于台商所承受的压力我们也可想而知。那赖清德总统候选人也已经表达对台商的支持，台商不该成为中共野心的牺牲品。那我们在两岸如果要看到健康有秩序的经贸的往来，也希望对岸能够理解这种政治性的借选或者是施以台商的各式的与经贸无关与市场无关的政治压力，对于两岸之间的经贸往来都没有帮助。那当然我们在未来的这段期间也需要防范各种不同多元的借选模式，包含各式的认知作战。那我们在这个过程当中也不断的要教育自己，要能够辨别是非，要能够辨识假讯息，要能够辨识各式的外来影响力。那台湾要对自己的前途有信心，对自己的未来也要有信心。那针对第二个问题，刚刚在第一位记者提问的时候也有问到那这数十年来共产党都有个习惯，就是把人分类然后贴标签然后斗争但是我们这几十年来也看到这样子的贴标签是不太具有建设性的那我们坚持自由跟民主与其他曾经被制裁的 国际友人一样，会持续的捍卫我们应有的权利，也持续的捍卫我们的价值，包含自由民主以及台湾人民决定自己未来的基本利益。
Thank you. We'll take the fourth question now, perhaps from the international press. Maybe Joyu from the first row. Joyu Wang from the Wall Street Journal.
Hi, thanks for having us here. Just some quick questions. So, you know, given your time in DC, I'm just wondering, you know, like, how would you think, you know, Taiwan should manage, you know, different voices on the Capitol, you know, with some rather to be kind of, you know, hawkish. And especially when it comes to, you know, the US policy over Taiwan and perhaps China. And I guess more general, you know, we've just curious about, you know, what you think your experience in DC that might or might not, you know, be useful when it comes to dealing with relations with the U.S. and China, and perhaps, you know, also still the future of Taiwan. Thank you.
Well, your question was about how I manage the different viewpoints in D.C. And actually, I think my former experience in a very robust and loud and noisy Taiwan politics actually gave me a lot of... I should say it gave me a good foundation in handling different viewpoints. And my role in DC has always been a very delicate balance. You know, I have described myself as a cat warrior, figuratively, you know, describing the need to balance multiple stakeholders. And we've always taken a very balanced approach as we manage delicate politics of different viewpoints. But I think the overarching principle is that, first of all, as a Taiwan government representative, we never get involved in American politics. Number two, we have to forge bipartisan and unified support for Taiwan. We cannot afford to let Taiwan become an issue of partisan difference in American politics. So everything we do it in a bipartisan way. We do it in a way that maximizes support from our friends across the board, across the political spectrum in Washington, D.C., and outside of the Beltway, too. I spent a lot of time traveling to different states and capitals. Also, as part of my own experience, I understand what grassroots democracy is about. And I know that American support to Taiwan cannot be limited to the Beltway. We have to expand our support among the American public and the American people. And finally, I want to say that in this process of delicately balancing our relations across the political spectrum, we are truly grateful for all the support that's been extended to us over the years, especially as we have been put in a situation where the geostrategic challenges are formidable. And a rock-solid partnership with the United States is critically important right now.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now we'll open up the floor to the fifth question. Maybe one from the back, the very back, the gentleman had his hand up quite early. The second to left, this gentleman here, yes.
我们是日本电美丽电视台，不好意思，我不会说好中文，你听不懂的话，听不懂的话，我统计再说明。
我听得懂，很好，
谢谢。根据有的民调，蓝白合作成立的话，他们的支持率超过你们的支持率。对这个结果，你怎么分析？
那台湾在 解严之后，经过多次的民选，还有总统的选举哦，那我们民调起起落落的，对我们来讲哦，最重要的就是要持续的来扩大支持我们的力量哦。那么在近期发生的很多的对于蓝白合不合的讨论当中哦，事实上对我们来讲，我们能做的不是在旁边看着他们要吵架还是要和，而是让我们自己更好，来争取更多台湾人民对我们的认同。哦，那应该这是我们现在最重要的策略。
Next question from the local reporter. 今日新闻的佩君。
萧大使您好 ，Now News 佩君，想请问一下，您回来之后就随即投入辅选行程，并把辅选首战选在花莲。那想请教一下你们未来的辅选规划，然后以及如何跟赖清德分进合击。然后此外，您觉得您有什么特质可以在这场选举当中替赖清德加分，然后产生互补的效果？然后萧大使，您刚刚有讲到，就是说要扩大支持力，那有没有什么比较具体的方式？
针对未来辅选的规划哦，确实竞选总部帮我办的也就是安排要第一场参与的造势活动以及竞总成立活动就是在花莲哦。那虽然我的人生的第一场选举不是在花莲，其实早年是在台北市的北区哦，但是花莲却是我过去十年的青春哦。那这个十年在花莲耕耘，我有跟花莲乡亲非常深厚的情感哦，所以在十月二十六日的花莲的竞选总部我非常期待可以再次跟许多的花莲乡亲，还有好几年不见的老朋友能够再一次的见面。那有关我跟赖副总统，也是我们总统候选人之间的这个互补哦，或者是在行程的安排上哦，分进合集哦，这部分竞选总部也都在做非常紧密的规划。那其实外界对我们有没有互补有很多的讨论哦，但是我会同意来或答应来跟赖副总统一起加入这场选战，不在于我们有什么的不同，而是在我们有没有共同的理念跟价值哦。那我想我跟赖副总统一样哦，我们都是把这场选战当作是一个持续守护台湾民主价值哦，让台湾的民主持续进步，来强化我们国家的韧性哦，来面对各式的外来的挑战那这是一个非常沉重的责任哦，但是也是台湾人民长期栽培我们给予我们机会，也为我们准备在做铺路。那所以我也在未来这段期间会持续的就竞选总部的规划来就相关的行程做后续的分工那当然这个分工可以想见的除了花莲是对我来讲非常重要的地方以外那据我了解竞选总部也正在帮我安排一些跟各种不同的群体在透过网络也好，或者是透过实体的对话也好来做更多的互动希望可以就这个一些新的议题包含国际外交的经验甚至是包含许多我们在选战要推动的年轻人在意的一些话题来做意见的交换。
大使，我想因为时间的关系，我们大概还可以接受两题，我们就一样开放一题国际媒体，一题本国媒体。It's a very streamlined press conference because we've decided to provide the translation after the event, which allows us to ask a bit more questions. Now, yes, and on the fourth row, to the third left. Thank you.
Good morning, Ambassador Xiao. I'm Amy Changchen for the New York Times. We noticed that quite a lot of voters, especially young people in Taiwan, seem to wonder why they should keep voting for the DPP after 7 years in power. We hear complaints about high housing prices and low income rises. Do you think young people's fatigue is a problem? And what's your answer to it? Thank you.
Well, the answer to why people should continue to vote for the DPP after 7 years is because we are the best. And we have presented the best set of candidates in the 2024 elections. But having said that, I also want to acknowledge the many domestic and social challenges that our young people are facing. I think there is a lot of anxiety over housing prices, over good-paying jobs, a sustainable environment. And these are also issues that the young people of many other countries face. While I was in the United States, as I traveled to the different cities, we also hear debates and discussions on these same issues. And I think it's important to recognize that these are very important topics for future generations. And I think the young people want to see some hope and opportunity in their future. And it is our responsibility to provide that roadmap. Our presidential candidate, William Lai, has had a series of policy pronouncements, press conferences, and we will continue to capture these issues in our discussions. But also, I think in my role in particular, as I bring to this team some extensive international experience, I would like to contribute more in terms of facilitating understanding best practices on a global level in how some of these issues that are important to young people are resolved or remedied or ameliorated in other societies. And I must admit, in the past 3 years, I've been primarily focused on security, economic relations, you know, international participation. But I think in the years ahead, if elected, I'd like to do more work on bringing in best practices on some of the domestic social issues that are top priorities of our future generations.
Okay, the last question for the press conference. 好，三立的冠志。
大使你好，我是三立新闻网的李冠志，我在这里。
哦，好，看到了。
我想请问你哦，因为前两天你说蔡总统有交付你这个在美国的任务，就是让世界在世界上架台湾。那你到美国去之前也列了任务清单哦，那过去三年期间，你觉得你完成了多少百分比的这个任务？就是说，在你的这个任务清单里面，有多少项是你完成的？有多少项是你希望未来当上副总统，然后成为执政团队的一员，然后希望推动的？那还有另外一个部分，就是说，过去推动外交工作，那你的亮眼成绩，其实大家也都看得到。那相信大家看不到的，就是你辛苦的地方，那以及可能心情比较不好的地方，那你在面对这样的情绪的时候，你怎么去排解？
哇，这个问题好广哦。首先哦，我三年半以前要赴任的时候，确实蔡总统有期望我在美国对于促进台湾的透过台美关系的提升来促进台湾的安全与繁荣都有一些交代。那我去到美国之后，这些当然都是非常重要的优先议题哦，包含我们好不容易可以启动的台美二十一世纪贸易倡议哦，那这也是经历千辛万苦终于有个起头。那另外在军事安全领域我们的合作也更深入也更广泛。当然这个过程里面，我觉得还是有一些未完成的工作哦。例如说，二十一世纪贸易倡议的谈判哦，还有后面几批的议题哦，要持续的处理。那另外呢，我今年这个年度非常努力的，我本来很期待我可以在任内完成签署的哦，就是避免双重课税哦，这是许多的台商国内的企业在做全球布局的过程当中 对于在美国扩大他们的布局以及影响力所提出非常重要的议题哦。那我们取得了非常重要的进展，包含国会两院民主共和两党的领袖都有极高度的认同，也已经提出了这个修法的草案。那这个部分已经临门一脚了哦，非常期待能够早日来落实。那这我相信也对于台美经济关系的深化是会有非常长远的影响。那当然其他的议题还很多有一些议题是在三年半赴任期没有想到自己会碰到的，所以在这三年半期间我事实上也学习了很多那包含供应链的韧性的问题那包含这个去向美方争取疫苗这件事情这个也是一个这个包含对整个法律的架构那甚至是疫苗的在美国生产的机制到后来捐赠的国际机制，我们都其实下了很多很多的功夫，这个背后是很难今天一语道之是非常冗长跟复杂也很辛苦的过程。但是我觉得很欣慰的就是我们驻美代表处有很多的阿信们曾经 Vincent 也是其中之一那我们驻美代表处的团队大家都是非常任劳任怨那在每一个议题上跟我一起努力，那让我们可以在这些议题上取得进展这个刚提到这个有没有心情不好情绪这个我觉得身为台湾人在国际空间这个领域而言做台湾人都是很辛苦的，因为我们面对的对我们不公平的国际的环境我们所遭遇到国际空间的打压以及我们国际地位的特殊性这过程当中确实会有很多的挫折但是身为台湾人，我们的特性也是这些挫折让我们更有韧性也让我们更懂得很务实的去找到达到目的的这个路径那所以在很多的议题上虽然千辛万苦我举这个双重课税议题为例我们回去看背景，我们这一题已经讲了40年，那现在终于能够取得具体的进展，也是我们整个团队还有历任代表大使们大家共同努力的成果那我们这个以情绪的角度来看我最担心的一件事是台湾的政治黑暗的政治漩涡我一直不想面对那一直觉得这个好不容易找到一个不用选举然后可以专心为国家做事的位置那我也很期待未来是可以继续专心的为国家做事不被这个不相干的议题所干扰那我们每个人的能量都是会全力的付出那但是这些能量如果可以聚焦在对国家具有建设性的议题上面应该对大家都是更好的所以这也是我对自己的期许。那每个人的成长历程都难免会有一些挫折我自己也是，但是每一个挫折跟每一个伤口都是我们成长的养分也成为我人生历练非常重要的一部分那这些历练我相信也让我现在更坚强更有能力来面对各式的内外的挑战。